Respected brothers and sisters in Al-Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command is to know who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. It is not only just for us Muslims, as it goes even for those who are kuffar. If we look at the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded in Surah Muhammad saying that fa'lam, and know, have the knowledge, annahu la ilaha illallah, that there is no deity worthy of worship in truth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it is upon all of us Muslims, those who claim that we are Muslims, it is upon every one of us to seek knowledge. It is upon every one of us to know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. It is upon every one of us to know what would negate our belief. It is upon every one of us to know what would take us to Jannah. It is upon every one of us to know what would secure us in the Akhirah. This knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, foremost of all, cannot be bargained with. You cannot trade this with something else. Why? Because the moment you try to trade this with something else, you are gonna be amongst the loser for eternity. And there are many, many cases that we see. Many, many bad examples that are in front of us as to how we are gonna be doomed eternally, as to how people actually lost not only the dunya but also in the akhirah by being dead upon the misguidance, by being dead upon not knowing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted from him or her in this dunya. What we see in ourselves, unfortunately, is how we can be bigger than others. What we see in ourselves, unfortunately, is how we can actually compete against each other in the dunya. What we see in ourselves is how we can be on the top of everything. And this is the human being's nature. But if we look at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was on the top of everyone, as well as on the top of everything. In terms of what? In terms of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In terms of not disobeying the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because even the messengers alayhi wassalatu wasalam, from the time of Adam alayhi salam till Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, every one of the messengers and prophets, they were warned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to disobey the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who are we then? We are in the worst scenario when it comes to disobeying the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Vast majority of us, if not all. So when we are in this scenario, there is a way out in the Quran and the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yet, we show our backs. Yet, we are arrogant. Yet, we don't care. Why? Because this will drag us backward. That is the mentality that we are having now. That connecting to the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's deen is proven to be backwardness. Whereas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding us to rush towards His forgiveness. Why? We are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not majboor to forgive us. Rather, we are majboor to beg His forgiveness. It means nothing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's names, Al-Ghaffar, Al-Ghafoor. The amount of sins that we are accumulating, the amount of arrogance that we are having in ourselves, the amount of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forget about the people, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we are talking about. We are not realizing that in this state, if we die, then the punishment of the Jahannam, may Allah forbid, would overpower the pleasure of Jannah in every way possible. Wal'iyadu billah. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means nothing. And that is the harshest reality that we are in. We are not here to give you the stories where you can gain many benefits. At the end of the day, that would be our jobs to continue reminding you, warning you. But when it comes to the warnings, do not be offended. Why? Because the minbar always should be used to warn people. I'm not in a position where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he used to give khutbah, his face would have been extremely red out of anger. People would have been sleeping. I'm not here to actually demolish you. But the seriousness that I'm trying to portray here, the points that I'm trying to emphasize, take heed, O servants of Allah. Why? Because in pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in preferring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mahabba and His forgiveness and His mercy, in preferring the akhirah, where the akhirah would be everlasting for eternity, you would have the success in the dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is why He said, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. Hayat al-dunya, the life of the dunya, is nothing except the mata'ul ghurur, the enjoyment, where we compete against each other, where we would like to be on the top of everything. After this verse in Surah Ali Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَتُبْلَوُنَّ فِي أَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنفُسِكُمْ وَلَتَسْمَعُنَّ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا أَذًا كَثِيرًا. You would be tested with your wealth and with your lives, with your souls, and you would hear from those who were given the books before you, the Christians, the Jews, and those who committed shirk. And those with shirk, they caused pain, not only towards themselves, but also to the mass community with the shirk, wal-iyad billah. And every one of us is being affected by shirk. My dear brothers and sisters, there is nothing to be denied when it comes to the shirk. And we are getting involved into the shirk so much so that we are not realizing that we are in shirk. Wal-iyadu billah. Major shirk, minor shirk, hidden shirk, and the list goes on. That is why shirk would destroy all the actions that you are piling up, even if a single good action that you have, and that means nothing to the society. That means nothing to the community. One, look at the dalil in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ. If you have committed shirk, meaning if you have associated partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in terms of His lordship, in terms of His worship, in terms of His names and attributes, even one action that you have done sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in accordance to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or in accordance to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that has been voided, nullified, destroyed just for committing shirk. وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. You would be from those who are losers. And those who understand Arabic, lam with fatha, wala, it actually is lam with tawkeed, lam of assurity, lam of assurance, meaning for sure you will be amongst the losers. Don't think that you will be victorious unless you sincerely repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, unless you sincerely renew your iman. Knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is really crucial, my dear brothers and sisters, because only knowing the haq about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us success in the dunya as well as in the akhirah. Or else we would be no different than those who talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without knowledge. Meaning we are disobeying the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want us to be ignorant. And the way we will not be ignorant about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is when we follow the command, i'lam. That is why five daily prayers, the way it is obligatory upon us, without the prayers, we cannot even call ourselves Muslims. Similarly, knowing or having a knowledge or seeking knowledge is another obligatory act. And by doing so, you are benefiting in many ways. You are not remaining ignorant. You are gaining reward. You are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by seeking knowledge. And the benefits, list of the benefits, go on. So that is something every one of us need to pay attention to. That is something every one of us should compete against each other. Dare I say, every one of us, while we are seeking knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should have the tendency, or we should have the mindset, that this knowledge, insha'Allah al-Aziz, will take us to Jannatul Firdaus al-A'la. And that should be our aim, rather than competing against each other in the dunya. The moment we are dead, the moment we are buried 6 feet under the ground, this competition would mean nothing. Wallahi, every one of us will be forgotten, the competitions that we were doing in the dunya. So take heed, O servants of Allah. Wallahi, the success of the akhirah would be determined by what you are doing in the dunya. The lifespan that we are given, O servants of Allah, if we are utilizing that, if we are utilizing that in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ta'atullah, according to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then there will be falah, there will be success, khayr in the akhirah. Otherwise, we will be the losers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from the external and internal evil influences of the shayateen, from the mankind as well as the jinn kind. Allahumma ameen. Nafa'ani Allahu wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayat wa dhikr al-hakim. Wa bihadi sayyid al-mursaleen. Aqulu ma tasma'un. Wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'ir al-muslimin min kulli dhanbin fastaghfiruhu wa tubu ilayh. Innahu huwa at-tawwab ar-rahim. Innahu huwa al-ghafur ar-rahim. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillahi ala ihsanihi wa shukru lahu ala tawfiqihi wa imtinanihi. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah ta'ziman li sha'ni. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu adda'i ila ridwanihi sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawmiddin. Allahumma la 'ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal 'alimul hakim. Allahumma 'allimna ma yanfa'una warfa'na bima 'allamtana ya rabbal 'alamin. Dear brothers and sisters in Al-Islam, you heard me saying about shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in three ways. Number one, Ar-Rububiyyah. Number two, Al-Uluhiyyah. Number three, Al-Asma wa Sifat. Ar-Rububiyyah, the Lordship. Al-Uluhiyyah, the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Asma wa Sifat, the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the scholars, Sheikh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab Al-Wasabi Al-Abdali Al-Yamani, not to be confused with Sheikh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab Ibn Sulaiman Al-Tamimi, who died in the year 1206 after Hijrah. The one that I was talking about, he died maybe 50, 60 years ago. So he came, and this is one of the istinbat, this is one of the benefits. And this is the fourth category of Tawheed that he understood. And this is something for us actually to go through. That is Tawheed al-Mutaba'ah. We have Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, al-Rububiyyah, al-Asma wa Sifat, and this is Tawheed al-Mutaba'ah. What does Tawheed al-Mutaba'ah mean? Tawheed al-Mutaba'ah means that singling out in imitation, singling out in following, singling out in only copying Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Look at the verse in Surah Al-Ahzab where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. And remember, in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, great example. For who? For those, لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. Those who seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day. وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. And those who seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and focus on the last day, leading to the akhirah. Their characteristics would be that they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not only just for the mankind, but for the whole universe or whatever that exists in this world. If Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not being followed when it comes to the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not being imitated when it comes to pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam means nothing, rather the other prophets and messengers, and this is for the kuffar, those who deny Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those who deliberately deny, not out of ignorance in most cases, because the trend is changing now. And the trend is that the more you slander Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wal'iyadu billah, and this is the attack from the kuffar now, the more inferior us Muslims will become. We would start doubting upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is the reality that we're in. We can claim that we are from Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah in an Indian subcontinental way, or in Arabic way, we can claim that we are min Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Would mean nothing if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being disrespected in gathering, if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being humiliated in the majlis, if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not being followed, then the ibadatullah wahdahu la sharika la, in al-rububiyya, in al-uluhiyya, in al-asma wa sifat, would mean nothing. Again, you are destroying all your good actions that you have piled up simply because you did not follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, simply because you went against the evidences that are in the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How can we know that sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How can we know that there is evidence? We look at the aqwal of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We look at the af'al, the actions, the verbal statements, the actions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We look at the taqrirat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, things that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam approved of. We also look at things that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not do so. Doesn't mean that we would do so simply because there is no evidence. If there is no evidence, if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not do so, we do not have right to say in the name of nothing gonna be wrong if we do so. So be careful, O servants of Allah, because following of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam means following Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the dalil for that, man yuta'i rasul faqad ata'a Allah. Whosoever obeyed the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then he obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is how simple the religion of Al-Islam is. But due to our own desires, we are complicating things. And as a result, we are becoming worse than animals. How so? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-A'raf, وَلَقَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنْسِ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْغَافِلُونَ. Allah gave us all these blessings. Whether we are being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not, that's a different issue. But when these things are present in front of us, the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are still ignoring them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us eyesight. We are not looking at it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the aql, gave us the things that we need to understand. And it is easy to understand. Yet, we do not understand. When the eyesight is given, we do not see. Then the ears that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us to hear, we do not hear. Even if we would like to hear, we hear it and let it go with the other. Unfortunately, that is not the worst. The worst is when someone knows the truth that person A is about to say to person B stops person A to say, please do not say this, or else I will be bound to follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. So that is arrogance coming in. And there are, unfortunately, people. They would literally stop you from saying what is haq. And this is from the Muslims. I'm not talking about from the kuffar. This is from the Muslims. We need to be careful, O servants of Allah. Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ. They are like four-legged animals. بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُ. This is Allah. If you have problem with me, go deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this matter. Allah is saying, بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلْ, rather they are worse than the four-legged animals. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْغَافِلُونَ, they are heedless. Let us not be from those who are ghafilin. Let us not be from those who are going to end up losing the dunya as well as the akhirah. Let us be from those who are always seeking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the sins that are committed knowingly and unknowingly. Let us go on the path of the Salaf al-Saleh that will lead us to the ultimate success in the akhirah. Let us be from those who, for them, dunya meant nothing. Let us be from those who are servants of Allah, who would like to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who would like to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah. Let us be from those who would like to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The best of the best reward would be in Jannah al-Firdaws al-A'la. عباد الله اعلموا أن الله أمركم بالصلاة والسلام على نبيه وقال في محكم التنزيل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وعن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من صلى علي صلاة واحدة صلى الله عليه عشر صلوات وحط عنه عشر خطيئات ورفع به عشر درجات رواه الإمام أحمد في مسنده فصلوا وسلموا على سيد الأولين والآخرين اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن خلفائه الراشدين الأئمة المهديين الذين قضوا بالحق وبه كانوا يعدلون أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة أجمعين وعنا معهم بعفوك ومنك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وذل الكفر والكافرين وانصر عبادك المؤمنين المستضعفين في كل بلدان المسلمين يا رب العالمين اللهم كن للمستضعفين عونا وظهيرا وهيئ لهم من لدنك وليا ونصيرا اللهم عليك باليهود المعتدين وسائر الكفرة الظالمين اللهم قذف الرعب في قلوبهم وأنزل بهم بأسك الذي لا يرد عن القوم المجرمين يا قوي يا عزيز ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واعف عنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وأنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقم الصلاة
غرباء غرباء غرباء